Pino ran his racket of sex, drugs, and contract killings from a sleazy hotel in a slum block of tenements. The NYPD was closing in. I could hear the sirens. Their wail was a crescendo. Lupino thought he could get us by taking Alex out and leaving me to take the fall for it. All he had gotten was my attention. Lupino wasn't in his cheap hotel. Instead, I ran into the Finito brothers. My cover had been blown, the door slammed shut behind me, and then I was dodging bullets like raindrops. Rackets through his right-hand man, Vinny Gagmiti. Gagmiti was a high-strung whiner on the verge of breaking apart, like an over-amped Energizer bunny. He had the brains to run the business, but he lacked the balls, always falling short, taking his frustration out on underage addicts and call girls.
The V deal goes down at your hotel. Jack's exact words, quote, Vinny, you're in charge of this one, unquote. Rico Muerte is coming to see you through. Anything goes wrong and everybody's gonna get dead. Goes double for you. Treat this guy real good. Anything he wants, you give him. Don't screw this up or you're finito, finitos.
A V deal meant added security, locked doors, and lots of nervous thugs with itchy trigger fingers. I'd seen nothing coming in, but that didn't mean it hadn't been there. Rico Muerte was a regular Kaiser Soze, a spook story told to keep the apes in line. 313. The Finitos had scribbled Muerte's room number on the note's margin.
trusted boys as a monkey the size of King Kong on his back. And we need your special skills for backup on a major deal.
Collecting evidence had gotten old a few hundred bullets back. I was already so far past the point of no return, I couldn't even remember what it looked like when I had passed it. Big time hustler.
Who the hell?
It's that cop.
Working with for his gun.